today we are part of the Vibrant Gujarat delegation, which has come to New York for promoting the Vibrant Gujarat upcoming summit, which is scheduled to be held in January 2022. The delegation yesterday first visited the Indian Diaspora event in New Jersey, where more than 225 participants were present to understand the upcoming summit and the opportunities that the Gujarat offers to the entrepreneurs. Today we had a financial services roundtable in New York at the Consulate General of India in New York in his office, and more than 45 financial services players from various segments participated. There was a huge interest from the financial services participants to know about the GIFT City project of the Government of Gujarat, which is setting up India's first international financial services center. This is unique because a lot of global investors always look at the financial center to participate into India and to the global market, and thereby the role of GIFT City was very well appreciated. We have seen a great amount of interest from the fund industry, from the banking industry, and various financial services players. We continue to see larger participation of new entities and new products which can be brought in the GIFT City. Today's roadshow ended with a very positive note of inviting the financial services players to the upcoming January 10, 2022 Vibrant Gujarat Summit, and there was a huge interest to participate and come to Gujarat and experience the international financial services at GIFT City Gujarat. Thank you.
We're seeing in India right now in the economy, things are really picking up. The economy's going to grow at 9% this year, and again, probably 8.5% next year. And again, that's a sign of the continued enthusiasm and the continued optimism that business has for investing in India. And the CG mentioned that foreign direct investment was a record $82 billion, I think you said. This past year, and again, that was India is one of the few countries in the world where FDI was positive over this past year. So again, we've heard a lot of information about GIFT City, about the IFCA, and I just wanted to introduce myself and introduce USISPF to all of you and say that we're here. We're based in the United States. Our headquarters are in Washington, D.C., but we have offices in four other cities here in the United States, including here in New York, plus offices in Delhi and Mumbai. So we're a partner in all of this. We're a strong partner with the government of India, with the consulate, with the embassy in Washington, and we look forward to working with all of you as you move forward in your investigations of GIFT City and IFSC. Thank you.
My question was, this is a lot of conversation on attracting financial capital. Could someone talk a little bit to how you're attracting local human capital, which is equally important in the equation? And I know there's a lot of it in India, but how are you bringing it to this place?
I think we are sitting here. We went to yesterday at the diaspora event. We went to other financial centers. Out of 10 people we meet, 7 to 8 are into financial services from India. And out of 8, you will find 4 from being Gujarat, in the financial services working globally. So the talent was always there in Gujarat. The opportunities earlier were more into printing and manufacturing. That's where we utilized. So a lot of large Bangalore-based institutions source their talent from Baroda, MS University, for example. And a lot of Gujarat talent is all over the place. So what we have found is, recently when Bank of America started their Global In-House Center, for their own requirements, 75 to 80%, they could find the local talent available for their operations. Only 20% of the staff also came from other parts of India. Or from Gujarat, IGF City, your sources, Gujarat itself, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, all this talent are all coming to the IFFC zone. We are not finding that challenging as on date. But as we move forward, we are creating large number of jobs. Obviously, there will be much more higher the requirements of the resources coming in. And fortunately, Gujarat has created the required knowledge corridor. So we are guided by the IIT Gandhinagar, which is just 3 kilometers from the GIFT City. We have Gujarat Digital Law University, which is just in the opposite side of GIFT City, in the very much vicinity. Then we have IIT. Then we have Petroleum University, we have IIM Ahmedabad, lot of finance, a lot of institutions are available and talent. We are not seeing that as a challenge right now.
To your question, I would like to just further elaborate. It has been quite sad that in the IT, Gujarat has not been at the forefront. Yes, IT, I mean Bangalore, Hyderabad, Pune, and Noida region in India took early lead. Because typically Gujarati spirit was that of doing business, not so much the services. So in the initial stage, there was a dearth of probably such people. Let me give two examples. When TCS opened a center right in Gandhinagar, they are having more than 6,000 people working for them. In Gandhinagar alone, there are more than 20,000 people who are working for technology sectors. More importantly, now two sectors which are catching up in big way, and I mean jokingly I give that example, you pick up all the top chartered accountants and company secretaries in India, out of 10, 4 will be from Gujarat. Financial sector as well as legal sector, these are the two big emerging areas where Gujarat is at the forefront of providing skilled manpower. Further to that, what we have added is lot of hinterland catchment which hitherto was not really explored. So manpower availability, particularly at the highest skill level, will no more be an issue. And if some particular industry do feel that this particular area is still lacking, we are constantly working at those levels that if such manpower has to be trained, the skill, then we have created universities and the whole. I mean, I'll just tell you, if you were to walk or go to GIFT, you pass through what is called Knowledge Garden. There are 5 universities on the way, which are all created in the last 10 years. So manpower, we understand that is one of the critical requirements for any financial service center, and we are at it.
Oh, session was very interesting. We have been working with GIFT City and GIFT City regulators for some time now. There are a lot of new things that they are doing, and it's always good to know new developments from them of what has recently happened. You know, for example, learning about them coming with the spec-like structure where India will have their own spec in GIFT City. It was very interesting to know.
I think today in New York it was very interesting. I think it was a financial sector roundtable, and we had people from banking, broking, various other asset managers. I think one of the best things today is that came out is that India as an opportunity continues to be very exciting, and there are going to be the access into India maybe going forward through GIFT City. But I think it was really heartening to see the kind of interest, the questions which came. I think we are very clear. India remains, basically India is moving towards a $5 trillion economy, and I think it's just a matter of time. And the kind of interest that we have seen in New York makes us very encouraging.
My name is Kapil Rathi, co-founder and CEO of Crosstower. Crosstower is a digital asset exchange with capital market focus. We are here joining the GIFT City delegation, learning about different type of programs that GIFT City is rolling out for a fintech organization like us. I'm really intrigued by some of the regulatory development that GIFT City is bringing, especially very excited that there is a single regulator, especially in the blockchain and digital asset space. There is a lot of regulatory uncertainty. Having a regulator that can actually provide some clarity in addition to some of the sort of infrastructure to build a digital asset-based platform. We are a blockchain company. We're looking to expand aggressively in India. We're currently based out of Gurgaon, but this actual presentation has helped us learn quite a lot about the GIFT City program. And it is definitely something that we are actively considering to work with the government officials and regulators.
My name's Kristen Boggiano. I'm the co-founder and president of Crosstower, and it was such a delightful event today, so informative, really giving us an overview of the efforts of Gift City to attract foreign investors, which is really putting in an incredible framework, frankly, that goes across many different industry, asset management, capital markets. Really well done today. Thanks very much for having this. It was something I'd come to again.